Hey everyone, this is Suki from F2Pool. Guess what today? I'm going to show you the free new ASICs for Ethereum mining. Yeah! If you are mining or if you're interested in mining or interested in Ethereum, anyway, just follow me because I will show you the secret of wealth. Let's go! We just received 3 miners today and all of them are from Sun Moon Jasminer series. Let's just focus on this little guy first. Do you believe this is an ASIC miner? And yes it is. It's only 4.8 kilo warm with no cooling fans and even noiseless. That means you can mine at home. With a hash rate of 65 MHz per second and power consumption of 30 watts. It has a total unit power consumption of 0.46 watts per MHz. That's the key parameter from its official site. Let's move to the second one. It looks like an IDC server, right? But actually, it's also an ASIC miner. The next one is the X41U miner, with 520 MHz per second hash rate to ETH hash comps, and power consumption of 240 watts. If you were not told that this is a mining machine, you may just think it of like a standard one unit server in a big data center or something. Although it does have a built-in fan, it is way quieter than a common ASIC. The chip technology is the same, with the same unit power. However, the one you has more chips than the brick. And the third one is the boss of today. Now we have the third one called ETH hash server, the most powerful one in this series. It can be easily spotted as a typical ASIC, and it is larger and it provides 2500 MHz per second hash rate, with 1200 watts of power consumption. The server houses the same chip technology, but because it is much more powerful, it also includes two cooling machines and a built-in PSU. So we have gone through some background and quick view, but how about the hashway power consumption which they can actually mine? Let me show you. Let's test it! Before we introduce the pricing, as well as show you more detail inside each of them, we are going to run the miner and see the actual numbers they can bring. Just stay with us. Our machines are now connected to the same internet as the Mac I am using. But before starting mining, we still need to create an account on the mining pool. So let's get to make an F2Pool account. The process is simple. First, click create account on the F2Pool homepage. From there, you will need to enter your account name. I will use Suki on the Moon for my account. I will add subaccounts for each of 3 miners for a more clear display of the data. After we have connected the Jasminer to my Ethernet and log into the backend page, you can now set up the configuration on this page. Here is a bit more information about its products. Jasminer was created by Sun Moon. This company has a history of 12 years focused on high throughput chips, and they offer high-end solutions for both computing and storage. After it's fully warmed up, here is the power consumption. How about the price? On its official site, they are listed at 1,855, 9,740, and 48,700 for small to large respectively. You may refer to the official website in the description box to check the latest price. After a weekend, let's compare the local and the pool hash rate. The hash rate stabilized at 64.95 MHz per second on local. And when you check out the dashboard on F2Pool, the valid hash rate is also similar. We mined 0.00151884 Ethereum per day with the break. This is about $4.94 at an Ethereum price of $3,249. And minus the power cost with the rate of 15 cents kilowatt hour, we earn about $4.82. Using the same method to calculate, we earn about $37 with the 1-year miner, and also $182.44 with the biggest one. How about Ethereum Classics? We will spend another few days mining to test the hash rate and get the revenue. To mine Ethereum Classics, we follow the same steps. We will need to use the same supercans to do the configuration, as well as track the hash rate charts. We mine 0.063288867 Ethereum Classics per day with the blank. As an Ethereum Classics price of $71, and minus the power cost with the weight of 15 cents kilowatt hour, we earn about $4.37. Using the same method to calculate, we earn $32.26 with the 1U miner and $153.24 with the biggest one. So now you can calculate the static ROI period, and taking the brick model mining Ethereum Classics as an example, it will take 425 days to get the cost back. Device memories is another factor for an ETH hash miner apart from the hash rate and power consumption. This is because people need to store that file, which grows larger day by day, and a Jasminer equipped with the 5GB of memories. To mine ETC, you can mine till the beginning of 2029. Some may think that, hey, Ethereum chain is now turning from the proof of work to proof of stake. Does it mean that this miner becomes useless as the time goes by? No, not really. Even with the future Ethereum mesh to proof of stake, these devices can still support mining ETC. Sound not bad, isn't it? After unboxing and testing, we found that the whole setup process was quite smooth, and also the hash rate is quite similar to what the manufacturer had provided. Except for the big one, the other two are quite flexible in terms of their space requirement, even if they are ASICs. So what do you think about the three new miner? Tell me your thoughts below. And also you can check about our description box for more details. I also suggest you can do some estimation and the comparison using our mining calculator. Don't forget to like and subscribe before you go. Bye for now, and I will see you guys soon.